reaction to Hillary Clinton suggesting that Democratic presidential candidate Tulsi Gabbard is getting help from the Russians?
I think they've got their eye on somebody who's currently in the Democratic primary. She's a favorite of the Russians. They have a bunch of sites and bots and other ways of supporting her so far.
All right, let's talk about this. Let's bring in Wajahat Ali. He's contributing op-ed writer for the New York Times, and Kristal Ball, president of the People's House Project. She was also a Hillary Clinton supporter. Great to see both of you. So, Kristal, why is Hillary Clinton picking this fight with Tulsi Gabbard? Why now?
Well, I think it's pretty obvious what's going on. You know, in those same comments, Hillary Clinton blames Jill Stein for her loss, which is ridiculous. I don't know if Jill Stein or the Russians made Hillary not campaign in Michigan, Wisconsin. And here she has sour grapes over Tulsi Gabbard backing her primary rival, Bernie Sanders. I mean, it is truly disgusting and absurd to smear an American veteran, a member of Congress, a presidential candidate, as a Russian asset and say specifically that they are grooming her baselessly to throw out such a wild accusation. It's pretty disgusting.
This is interesting, Kristal, because, I mean, as we said, you were a Hillary Clinton supporter and you're disgusted by what she's doing. Do you think that Tulsi Gabbard deserves any criticism for some of her positions?
I mean, in fairness, I was actually a Sanders supporter in the primary, just to be clear
for
your audience. Yeah. Look, I'm not here to defend every single thing that Tulsi Gabbard has done or said. But I think what this shows is the insanity of seeing Russia around every single corner that has gripped some of the conspiratorial parts of the Democratic Party. Here's the other thing that's at stake. Whether you like Tulsi Gabbard or not, if you hold unorthodox or anti-establishment or even radical ideas at all, this is a danger because it means you too can be dismissed and smeared as a Russian asset. So that's why I think this is so important.
Wajahat, is that how you see it? Do you think that Tulsi Gabbard just holds unorthodox comments and that Hillary Clinton has gone way overboard?
I think Tulsi Gabbard is a terrible candidate based on her positions alone. But Russian outlets seem to love Tulsi Gabbard. So does MAGA, so does Steve Bannon, so does David Duke, so does alt-right's Richard Spencer. And she supports pro-Assad and pro-Russian talking points, especially when she visited Syria in 2017. It took her forever to criticize Assad, a brutal dictator. I wish she was half as critical against Assad as she was, as she is against Clinton in her tweets. Look, Hillary Clinton is aware of the fact that Russia had a disinformation campaign in the 2016 elections to help Donald Trump. They're still actively engaging in a disinformation campaign. They will continue this campaign leading up to 2020. As we know, Robert Mueller testified to this point. Tulsi Gabbard can be a useful idiot. In order to be a Russian asset, Allison, you don't have to be a witting or a willing participant. Jill Stein was promoted by pro-Russian outlets and bots. And also, let's not forget, she was there clapping it up with Putin at the RT propaganda dinner, along with Michael Flynn, Donald Trump's first national security advisor. So you have to ask yourself, why are pro-Russian outlets and pro-Russian bots and MAGA and Steve Bannon and Tucker Carlson, by the way, loving Tulsi Gabbard? And it could be because they want to see her as a spoiler candidate. And in August on CNN, she said that she is open to considering a run as a third party candidate. I think she will. And I think that might hurt the Democrats.
She's ruled that out. And this is, I mean, this is guilt by association. You remember when the right tried to do this to Barack Obama with Reverend Wright, et cetera, et cetera. And because you've been in a room with these people, you must believe their views. They must support you. And what, because they support you, that means you're out of bounds. It's red baiting smear. Look, nobody has been more helpful to Russia than all the people who pushed the Iraq war, okay? To include Hillary Clinton. So does that make her a Russian plant? No, of course not. We can't run around saying, oh, because this person supports you, because we don't like your views on this, which again, I'm not supporting her views. But to say she's being groomed by Russia, to accuse her of treason, an American military veteran who served in Iraq, stitching up and mending our brothers and sisters who fell in that war, thanks to people like Hillary Clinton, I think that's just wrong.
And the same veteran promotes us the talking points. It took her forever to call him a war criminal. She calls U.S.-backed groups in Syria terrorists. She says it's a regime change. These are all against pro-Assad and pro-Russian talking points. And by the way, Tulsi Gabbard is not all of a sudden anti-war. She calls herself a war hawk, and she says she's against the terrorists. So she has backed Russian bombing of Syrian civilians. She is also a big fan of Sisi. She's also a fan of Modi, a Hindu nationalist and anti-Muslim extremist.
I'm not here to be a spokesperson. I'm not here to support her. I'm here to say, deal with her specific policy positions. Do not smear and dismiss her as a Russian asset. What is your evidence that Russia is grooming her? I mean, that was the specific language here. That's accusing a veteran of treason,
I just want to be clear about one thing, because Hillary Clinton's spokesperson, Nick Merrill, said that that first sentence that Hillary Clinton said, and I'll read it to you, I think that they've got their eye on somebody who's currently in the Democratic primary, that she was referring to the Republicans. She was asked about the Republicans, and she was basically, I mean, this is according to after the fact, what Nick Merrill says, saying that she thinks that the Republicans will somehow use Tulsi Gabbard as a spoiler. So yeah. I don't know that Hillary Clinton said that she was being groomed by the Russians.
Yeah, but Nick Merrill also said, if the nesting doll fits. I mean, come on, this is absurd. And look, you may not like Tulsi Gabbard. That's fine. I don't have a problem with that. But you cannot just dismiss people that you don't like as Russian plants. And you know that this goes so much further than Tulsi Gabbard. I mean, I've been accused of being a Russian plant just for pointing out some of the problems in America. Anyone who stands against the endless wars gets accused of being a Russian plant. Anyone who dares criticize the national security state gets accused of being a Russian plant.
Look, sorry to interrupt, Crystal, but she did go to on this, you know, so-called secret trip. At least it wasn't authorized by the government in 2017 to meet, you know, obviously in Syria, to meet with Assad. It was financed by the Lebanese Socialist Nationalist Party. She later had to repay it after criticism. So it's also actions. I mean, it's not just that she takes, as you said, unorthodox positions.
But here's my point, Allison, right? If we can say, okay, Tulsi had this meeting that we don't like, and that means she should be smeared as a Russian plant and dismissed from the national conversation, and yet we celebrate Ellen being friends with George W. Bush, a man who lied us into war and propagated torture under the American name and was never held accountable for that. I mean, hundreds of thousands of people died in that war, and that person is okay in polite society, but Tulsi Gabbard, because she had a meeting, is not. That doesn't make sense to me.
I think we should disqualify Tulsi based on her record, based on her positions, based on her associations. And you know who really loves Tulsi Gabbard? Pro-Russian outlets.
Okay. On that note, Wajahat Ali, Crystal Ball, thank you for the spirited debate.
Thank you, Alvin. Great to talk to both of you, John.
All right. The Cowboys snapped a 3-game losing streak in style last